Hi again. Could you tell me about your history with Bullet to the Head? What attracted you to the project, and what do you like about it?
Well, the script was sent to me, and I went over to talk to Sly about it, this very hotel, as a matter of fact. I told him I thought the material lent itself to being an homage back to action films of the 70s and 80s. It was territory that he certainly knew and that I certainly knew and that we had kind of moved our way along this treacherous business together, well, in parallel step back in those days. And I thought that the way to do it was not in any, you couldn't do it as parody or anything like that, or at least I couldn't. Do it pretty straight ahead, but at the same time leave room for the humor. And if we could kind of get a couple of jokes in there, but make the Jeopardy work, again, at a contained level. It's a hard thing to talk about in the sense that the overall surrounding world of the thing is totally non-realistic. This is a real once upon a time situation. But the characterization within the once upon a time situation is pretty straightforward and realistic. And the action is meant to be crunching. So,
when you say, is that something that you, when you say that it's realistic action, realistic characterization within an unreal circumstance, is that kind of what you mean by a throwback to the kind of 80s style of action cinema? What do you mean by
that? Yeah, I think that's probably pretty good. I don't make a living coming up with definitions, but I think that's probably a reasonable one for the kind of action films of that period and probably before. Mm-hmm. I think we've moved to a new phase now. Obviously, the most popular action films are elements of science fiction and comic book now, and they use exaggerated special effect or exaggerated in comparison to the old days. But I think also the whole approach to character is very different. Mm-hmm. You know, the good people in the modern action movie are very, very good. They're very, very nice. And the bad people are very, very wicked. And to a kind of, there's a kind of comic book sensibility that is very popular, that people, you know, like and have fun with now. The older, the action films of the 70s and 80s tend to be people more in distress and darker personalities,
right?
You know, Lee Marvin or Charlie Bronson, or you know, these are more brooding sensibilities than you usually see nowadays.
What do you think of Sly? You've crossed paths with him a number of times over the years, but never gotten to work with him.
What do I think of him?
Yeah.
Well, I like the guy, number one. I mean, he's fun. I like talking to him. He's a great boxing fan, obviously, and so am I. He's in the Boxing Hall of Fame, something that he's very proud of and that I envy. So he's a very good actor, but he's a great star. He's been around a long time. He's got this thing that very few people have. He can pick a movie up and carry it on his shoulders. Only great stars can do that. He's got great physical equipment. That is to say, he's got great eyes and he's got that great voice. But the biggest thing he's got is a particular sensibility. I'd call it heart. Where the audience understands his emotions, reads through his emotions, identifies with those emotions, and roots for him. And that's, you know, that's a dynamite thing to have, and it's the reason he's still here. Although, again, I think a lot of times people, you know, Sly's, he is a good actor. He can read a line, and or if you go after him on the line, he can change it and do it another way. You know, he's people forget he was a trained actor, and he went through the process. He did his work. He went out and auditioned. He failed. He starved. He was angry. He was rejected. But we think of him as an instant success. But he did break through very young. But he went through the process, and he paid his dues. Not for very long.
What do you think he brings to the character of Jimmy Bobo?
Well, he brings what only he can bring, his unique personality and his star persona. So you immediately, it frames the tale in a way that somebody you've never seen before would make it a very different story. And the audience hopefully becomes more involved, and without question, becomes more involved because of his presence. I think they'll probably, if they like anything, hopefully, they will respond to the balance between the humor within the truth of the characters and the action sequences. And I think there's just the brevity and speed of the movie in the storytelling. I think that's a welcome relief from some of this style of a lot of films currently.
Excellent. Thank you, Walter.